Ukraine continues to defend its independence, and there is some news for today for you. Before we begin, please don't forget to like this video, write some comments and subscribe our channel to show your support for the Ukrainian people. This is Andriivka. The village for which a fierce struggle lasted for months was destroyed by the Russian occupiers and covered with shell craters. For observers, it's just a small plot of land on the map and the good news of liberation. For the participants, it is the names of friends and brothers in arms who found eternal life in battle. Over the past few days, the 28th Brigade of Ukrainian Armed Forces has destroyed most of the 57th Brigade of the Russians, the entire garrison in Kurdiumivka. Western analyst Tom Cooper notes that if the Russians do not counterattack, the village will be liberated in a week. There has also been success at the Klishchiivka-Andriivka line, where the Ukrainian Army have already crossed the railroad. Ukrainian Armed Forces continue to demilitarize the Russia. On the Zaporizhia direction near Novoprokopivka, the armed forces of Ukraine destroyed an APC by FPV drone and a T-72 by artillery. Both were initially spotted by a reconnaissance drone. This video once again demonstrates that the armed forces of Ukraine have an advantage over the Russian army in the field of drones. It is worth nothing that even Russian experts recognize this fact. On the Donetsk direction, aerial reconnaissance aircraft spotted two rare targets in one place, UR-77 Zmiy Gorynych. These are demining machines that produce powerful explosions. The drone was guided HIMARS, and after the strike, there was not even a wet spot left. Meanwhile, on the Tokmak direction, the Russians launched a series of counterattacks, trying to cut a wedge in Ukrainian defense. And this is a fierce battle of Artan with Russian occupiers. GUR discloses details of special operation in occupied Crimea. Reconnaissance man of the Artan Special Forces Unit of the Defense Intelligence of Ukraine landed on the western coast of the peninsula. The special forces man engaged in a fierce battle with the Russian invaders in the occupied territories, inflicting significant losses on the enemy. On the way back from a combat mission in Crimea, the Artan soldiers also fought a battle at sea. The Russian enemy tried to pursue the special forces on surface fast patrol boats with aviation support. On the Taurida direction, a costly Russian R-330 Zhytel electronic warfare station was destroyed. Over the past day, the Russian enemy carried out 13 airstrikes, conducted 24 combat engagements, and fired 915 artillery rounds. The missile and artillery units of the Taurida Defense Forces carried out 1,270 fire missions over the last day. The Russian enemy losses amounted to 323 people, in particular two Russian occupiers surrendered. Ukraine destroyed 44 units of Russian enemy military equipment, in particular 4 tanks, 12 APCs, 6 artillery systems, 1 MLRS, 9 UEVs, 10 vehicles and a unit of special equipment of the occupiers. Also 2 ammunition depots and another important enemy object were destroyed. This is all interesting news for today for you. Please do not stand aside, support Ukraine. Like this video, write some comments and subscribe our channel. Glory to Ukraine, glory to heroes!